Another key component to being successful while you're doing underwater navigation is, of course, practice. We encourage all our students to practice on land in a dry scenario and in a confined water or pool environment before they head out to open water to make a navigational dive. What's up, guys? It's Brian again from Lake Hickory Scuba and Marina, and we are on part two of our series of underwater navigation using a compass. In part one, we talked about all the different types of compasses out there and actually how you use them, not only how you attach them to you, but also how do you use them as far as the bezel goes and getting your navigational headings lined up. What we're going to focus on in part two now is how do you practice using your compass before you go out to open water. We actually encourage all divers, whether you're a student or you're a certified diver, to practice on dry land in a dry-based scenario where you can really line up headings and stuff, because you're going to have positive feedback. You're going to see that visual reference point that you're trying to line up to, and you're always going to have positive feedback as you're moving towards that object. Once you get good on land and you have the basic fundamentals of a compass down pat, then we encourage you to go over to a confined water or a pool environment to actually practice as well. Now, the navigational parts of the open water program are not all there as far as how in-depth they get in the navigational course. However, there are some great benefits to having navigation in the open water program. One of the things that we do is we save the navigation as one of the last skills that we teach during the open water course. And the reason is we want you to focus on the actual scuba skills themselves, and we want you to master those skills before we introduce the compass to you. One thing that I've noticed over the years is students will over-focus on the compass during the open water class, and what happens is some of their basic skills kind of get deteriorated over time. So we may have got them neutrally buoyant, we may have got that perfect kick pattern for them, but as soon as we introduce a compass, they start to over-focus on this, and their kick patterns kind of deteriorate back, say, into that bicycle kicking, and their neutral buoyancy kind of becomes negative buoyancy again. So we don't want them to over-focus on the compass. The other problem with over-focusing on a compass is the way you feel underwater. So when you're swimming with a compass, a lot of times you'll feel like your body's going one way or the other, and you try to overcompensate for it. And we just tell you flat out, trust the compass. But once again, you never want to over-focus. If I'm swimming using my compass and all I'm focused on is the compass, I may not see the object that I'm headed to, and I may actually run directly into it. Or I may miss the object altogether if I'm a couple of feet away from it. So I'm going to show you a neat little trick that I teach students to do so that they're not over-focusing on the compass. Once we're in the water with a student, we'll kind of have them get a line of sight with their heading or their destination that they want to go to, and they'll line up their compass with that point. Now, once they've lined up the compass, I kind of tell the guys to keep a lookout for any other type of reference point, say, between you and your end destination. And if you see a reference point, you want to be able to note that point. Now, let's say that this is just a line in the water. Typically, this is what I'll do with students in the water. As they're navigating, I'll shoot a buoy with a line. They'll line up their compass, they'll get their navigational heading, and then they will actually put their compass away and swim to that reference point, that line. Once they've reached a reference point, they'll pick their compass back up and they'll continue to make sure that they're on that same navigational heading. They'll pick a secondary reference point or their second destination, and then it'll simply swim to it without actually using the compass. Because once again, we never ever want to over-focus on the compass. So once you've got your navigational heading to your destination, see if there's a reference point that you can still see and focus on, swim to that reference point, then pick your compass back up, make sure you're still lined up with your target or your destination, and then you can continue on the swim. You can do the exact same thing, whether it's a straight navigational heading or say a reciprocal heading or a square or a triangle. You can still practice the same skill sets. All you need is some type of object to put in your pathway to create that reference point. Now, I want to show you a quick video of what a compass actually looks like as you're navigating. As you're swimming along, the key point is to make sure that the magnetic north needle stays lined up with them reference points on your compass or the index markers of your compass. If you start to get off and it sways from that, you'll know that you're not on your navigational heading. All you've got to do is simply turn your body to line the north back up with the index markers. Once you've reached your destination and you've turned the bezel to, say, south to line up with that zero marker on your compass or on the bezel, the index marker, then of course you just simply turn your body and north and the index marker of zero will line back up and you can run a straight reciprocal. But like I said, whenever you practice with your compass, do not over focus on the compass. Make sure that your basic scuba skills are there, that you can maintain neutral buoyancy, that you can hold trim in the water, and that you just don't over focus because you're not going to enjoy the dive. You're going to miss the cool things about that dive if you over focus on the compass. But guys, get out there and practice with your compass. Like I said, this is how we practice with our students both in the open water program and in the underwater navigation program. In part three, I'm actually going to take you out on a dive and I'm going to show you a reference point on the surface, show you how I line up the compass itself, and then I'm actually going to make a dive where you can't see the reference point underwater until you actually get there. So definitely stay tuned for that. Guys, if you got any questions on underwater navigation, please put it down in the comment section below. We really enjoy making these videos for you and we hope that they're educational enough that it makes you advance your career as a diver or just gives you more knowledge in general as a diver. Guys, I really appreciate you watching this video. If you liked it, smash that like button for me. Definitely share it as well. As always, make sure you follow us on Instagram and Twitter. Like us on Facebook. Pin us on Pinterest. Subscribe to us here on YouTube. And as always, guys, we appreciate your business.